Last year, at the Vatican in Rome, they asked the Pope, "Have you got a special message to kids of all ages in grade school and up to year eight? What would you like to say to them about Lent?" And this is what the Pope said. "As good as giving things up is in Lent, it is even better to take on things, especially to take on kindness. Kindness to others, especially those we may not like, especially those who are poor, or anyone who is sad or may be rejected by other people." Now, as we well know about the Pope, he practices what he preaches, and he gives us very good example. So I want to tell you about a day, not in Lent, but in November of 2013, when he did exactly what he just told us to do in Lent. The Holy Father has this big meeting with all these people in the Vatican on Wednesday, and then he gets in the Pope Mobile and he goes around the square blessing people and saying hello and waving to everybody. And on November 18, 2013, he didn't know it, but a very special person had come down from the north of Italy down to Rome to meet the Pope. And he was a person who has had a very, very difficult life. That's a man called Vincenzo Riva, and he suffers from a terrible disease called neurofibromatosis. For the adults here, we might remember a film called The Elephant Man. It is exactly the same disease that that poor man suffered from too. And the Pope saw him. He didn't know he was there. He saw him, stopped the Pope Mobile, and then look what happens next. That's Vincenzo's mother, Rita, who's there with the grey hair next to the Pope. And they tell the story that the next thing that happened was the Pope said, "I'd like you to come and have lunch with me." So they end up within an hour having lunch with the Pope. And during lunch, the Pope said, "Is there anything I can do for you?" And Vincenzo said, "Holy Father, it is very difficult for me to walk up and down the steps of the housing project I live in. And my mother, who is now 86, has to look after me every day and bring everything up the stairs and everything down the stairs. And we've applied for 5 years to either go in a building which has an elevator or to be in a ground floor, a first floor unit, an apartment. And we've been unsuccessful." Rita and Vincenzo tell the story that the Holy Father got up, walked over to the phone and rang the Prime Minister of Italy. It's good to have contacts, isn't it? But he told the Prime Minister what had happened, and within 3 weeks, Vincenzo and his mother were in a brand new flat. That's them in their brand new flat. The Pope's never told this story, but they have become quite famous. Now, I know that he's very difficult to look at, but he is the most loving, kind person you could possibly meet. Apparently, he's one of the loveliest people in the world. But when he was at school, all the kids teased him terribly. They bullied him. Because of his illness, he also has a smell, and so he doesn't have a whole lot of good friends and close friends. And one of the lovely things that happened because of this meeting with the Pope is all of a sudden he got new people who cared for him and loved him, and his mother then knew that he was going to be secure and safe. Lent isn't just about giving up chocolate or lollies or other things. They're good things to do, don't get me wrong. But the Pope's absolutely right. This Lent, and this is true for the adults as much as it's for the kids, let's take on something. Let's take on kindness. kind in what we say and what we do, what we post online. And let's especially be kind to anyone who we find it hard to like, who may be poor, who may be sad, and who may not feel as though they belong. Lent's about knowing our blessing and sharing it because Christ has been so good to us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.